Hello friends, we bring to you a story, Dr. Dolittle by Hugh Lofting. This is the very first chapter padabai of the story. Dr. Dolittle doesn't understand people, though he loved animals and would do anything for his animal friends. It is an exciting retelling of Hugh Lofting's beloved tale of animal adventures. Let's start now. Once upon a time, there was a doctor and his name was John Dolittle, M.D. He lived in a small town called Puddleby on the Marsh. Whenever he walked down the streets in his tall hat, everyone would say, "There goes the doctor. He is a clever man." And the dogs and children would all follow behind him. Even the crows that lived in church would go and nod their heads. The house he lived on the edge of the town was quite small, but it had lawn with stone seats and weeping willows. The doctor was very fond of animals and kept many kinds of pets.
Beside the goldfish in the pond at the bottom of his garden, he had rabbits in the pantry, white mice in his piano, a squirrel in the linen closet, and a hedgehog in the cellar. He had a cow with a calf too, and an old lame horse, and chickens, and pigeons, and two lambs, and many other animals.
But his favorite pets were Dab Dab the duck, Jip the dog, Gub Gub the baby pig, Polynesia the parrot, and Toto the owl. His sister Sarah used to grumble about all the animals and say they made the house untidy. One day, when an old lady came to see the doctor, she sat on the hedgehog who was sleeping on the sofa and never came to see him again.
"John, how can you expect sick people to come and see you when you keep all those animals in the house? If you go on like this, none of the best people will have you for a doctor," said Sarah.
"But I like the animals better than the best people," said the doctor.
"You are ridiculous," said Sarah and walked out of the room.
As time went on, the doctor got more and more animals and he had fewer and fewer patients. At last, he had only one patient left, Matthew Mugg, the cat meat man, who did not mind any kind of animals. He went around the street of the town with a tray full of meat stuck on skewers. Cat meat man usually got sick once a year. When he did, he paid the doctor sixpence. Sixpence a year was not enough to live on, and he kept on getting more pets, which cost a lot to feed them. The money he had saved up grew little and little. Then he sold his piano, but the money he got for that too began to go. And now, when he walked down the streets in his tall hat, people would say to one another,
"There goes the John Dolittle MD. There was a time when he was the best known doctor in the West Country."
But the dogs, cats, and children still ran up and follow him through the town.
Thank you, friends. Hope you all like this video. Please share your views and do not forget to press like button. Stay tuned for the next chapter. Bye-bye.